When a man looks up, as I did the other day, and suddenly realizes that his career is 50 years old, well, he kind of starts thinking a little bit about all the wonderful people he's met and about all the wonderful things that have happened to him. And when I start thinking like that, one of the things that really gives me a thrill is the memory of what happened to me on my radio program a few years ago. It was out on the West Coast, and on this show, they staged a revival that, well, it really gave me goose pimples. You know what the Rhythm Boys have always meant to me and my band. And on this particular show, the producer got all three of the boys together again, the first time they'd been together in years and years. I kept a recorded transcription of the show. It's one of my real prized possessions of all time. And now I'd like you to relive with me what happened that night when the announcer introduced the Rhythm Boys with...
Back in the days when they were singing with the Paul Whiteman Orchestra, Al Rinker, Harry Varis, and Bing Crosby were known as the Rhythm Boys. Later, they went their separate ways and on to fame. Rinker as a radio producer, Varis as the composer of I Surrender, Dear, and other hits, and Crosby as a caddy for Bob Hope. And now, here they are. Al Rinker.
Me.
Harry Barrett.
Me.
And Bing Crosby.
Who, me?
Well, boys, having you back makes this a mighty big day in my life.
We're glad to be back, Paul. You know, I'll never forget the first time we sang with the Whiteman Band.
Neither will I. We were so nervous and so jerky.
Yeah, we sure got over being nervous, didn't we?
Say, Harry, did Bing wear funny shirts back in those days, too?
Yeah, and he got last with these baggy pants, too.
Mr. Barris, you lie like a rug. My trousers were always straight. It was my knees that were baggy.
Bing, tell me, when did you boys start with the Whiteman Orchestra?
Well, Wilbert was back in 1927. There we were, three white-collar men with nothing to do because the laundry lost our collar. Of course, as singers, we weren't amateurs. We'd already sung in three places. Two bathtubs and a shower. Needing a job, we dropped in at Mr. Whiteman's office and were greeted by his secretary.
How do you do? What can I do for you?
Well, we're Harry, Allen, Bing,
better known as the Rhythm Boys.
Formerly known as Three Chips Off the Old Block, or the Woodman Spare That Trio.
We come to you direct from 6 weeks in the gopher room at Patty's Primrose Pagoda.
Right. Oh, right. I got bad news, fellas. Somebody else beat us to it.
What do you mean?
Look over yonder. There's another trio.
Oh, that's no trio. That's Mr. Whiteman.
Sorry. Can we see Mr. Whiteman, miss?
Mr. Whiteman's very busy, but you can see his manager, Mr. Blackman. He engages all talent. Oh, Mr. Blackman. Mr. Blackman.
Yes.
Yes, did you want to see me?
These are the Rhythm Boys. They say they're singers.
So you're singers, eh? Do you sing pretty?
We sure can, beautiful.
Now, you listen here. Are you guys any good? What are your names?
Well, I'm Harry Barris. I sing like Bing Crosby.
I'm Al Rinker. I sing like Bing Crosby, too.
What about you there? You, with the awning on.
I'm Bing Crosby. I sing like Dick Todd.
How about giving us a tryout, Mr. Badman? We can use this piano right over here.
Well, that's right. You're so nice to do this for us, mister. Can we use the piano right over there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What do you want to hear?
Well, do you chaps know it's only a shanty in old shanty town?
Know it? We live in it.
Maybe you'd like to hear a brand new tune we just wrote. It's called When I Was 8 and You Were 9, Together We Were 17.
Smash. Smash.
Hey, we got another one. We got another one that's very big for us.
Well, it's called When It's Oyster Picking Time in Okalachicola, I'll Muscle In on You, Mammy Oh My. Big song for us. Very big.
Hey, now, wait a minute. I know the tune.
What's that?
Mississippi Mud.
Before we start, let's loosen up.
Let's loosen up.
I love life and I'm...
Wait a minute. What's going on here?
Well, Mr. Whiteman, these are the Rhythm Boys. They're loosening up.
Excuse me. I thought they were falling apart.
Wait until you hear us, Mr. Whiteman. We've got a brand new idea that's a sensation.
What is it?
Well, while Al and I sing, Bing here goes boo 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 boo, boo 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 boo.
What happens when he sings?
The audience goes boo-boo-boo-boo.
Well, you go right ahead, boys. Ladies and gentlemen, it's that much-loved bit of Americana, the Rhythm Boys, Mississippi Mud.
Here's mud in your eye. What are you boys moaning about?
That Mississippi mud.
Oh, that's pretty. Oh,
when the sun goes down, the tide goes up, the darkies gather round and they all begin to shout. Hey, hey, Uncle Doug, dear, beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. Dear, beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. What a dance do they do? Lordy, how I'm telling you. They don't need no fan. They take the time by clapping their hands. Just as happy as a cow, chewing on a cut when the dogs beat the feet on the Mississippi mud.
Lordy, how they play it. Boy, they really sway it. Boy, that music thrills me. Boy, it nearly kills me.
When the sun goes down, the sweet time goes down, the darkies gather round and they all begin to shout. Hey, hey, Uncle Duddy, it's spring to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. It's spring to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. What a dance do they do? Lordy, how I'm telling you.
Whoever heard
they
of a merry
don't
man?
They don't need no band. Take your time by clapping their hands. Just happy as a cow, chewing on a cut when the darkies beat your feet on the Mississippi mud.
Say there, boy, did you say mud?
I said mud, son.
What are you getting at, lad?
I said that really black mud.
You know, speaking of mud and rain always reminds me.
Reminds you of what?
That I left my sugar standing in the rain and my sugar melted away.
His sugar melted away. I said his sugar melted away.
You didn't miss.
Sweeter than the sugar from the sugar cane. Why, I didn't mean to treat her that way.
He didn't mean to treat her that way. Why did you treat that girl that way?
I'm a bad boy.
Now, you know, I bet your sweetie thought that you were just the lowest kind of a kind.
Could be, could be.
You never realized she was so refined, did
my
you?
My sugar, huh?
That's right.
Irregardless and respective.
I just left my sugar standing in the rain.
And my sugar melted away.
Here's where we get hot. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Hey, hey, Uncle Doug. Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Boom.
What a dance do they do? Lordy, how I'm telling you. They don't need no band. Take the time by clapping their hands. Just as happy as a cow, chewing on a cut when the dog beats the feet, says the dog beats the feet, says the dog beats the feet on the Mississippi mud.
But I left my sugar.
Where'd you leave your sugar? Standing in the mud.
In the mud?
You know that filly can't run a lick in the mud?
Yeah, but you know, that was before Delmar.
That was before racing.
I'll bet she's plenty muddy now.
You've just heard an off-the-air recording of one of my biggest thrills. And I want to express my deep gratitude to Bing Crosby, Al Rinker, and Harry Barris for making all this possible. And I'd like to add that I'll never be able to repay the wonderful warm feeling I've had all through the making of these records. I don't know how I can ever express my true feelings to the illustrious alumni of the Whiteman Band. Not only for their tremendous musical artistry, but also for their wonderful friendship. And that goes for all of them. Jimmy and Tommy Dorsey, Eugene Weed, Hoagy Carmichael, Joe Venuti, and Jack Teagarden and Johnny Mercer. They've made my life a richer experience in more ways than one. And a very low bow to Enoch Light and the folks at Grand Award for conceiving and producing all this with such great fidelity and for making me a real happy guy. Thank you.